Hello students, today in our class we will learn about histogram. So first we define what is histogram. This histogram is a pictorial representation. Histogram is pictorial representation of grouped data in which class intervals are taken along the horizontal axis is what? X-axis. And class frequencies along vertical axis, that is y-axis. So now when we say class interval, it is given like 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40. And frequency, you can say 0 to 10. You have 5 people are there. Suppose if the in our like our test for 40 mark, the students who got between the class marks 0 to 10, 5 students. Between 10 to 20, 12 students. Between 20 to 30, 7 students. 30 to 40, 2 students. Okay. So we have this class interval and frequency. When you have class interval here, the first number we call it as lower limit. Is it not? LL, we have learned it, lower limit. And then here this part we call it as upper limit, which we call it as UL, lower limit and upper limit. So according to the histogram definition, this class interval, we represent it on x-axis, frequency on y-axis. First, we do the rough diagram. So in the graph, what we do, we draw the x-axis horizontal line, then we draw vertical line. Then what it is given, class interval here on the x-axis. So you know 0 is where they both intersect, 10, 20, 30, 40. And this is our class interval. And on y-axis, we have frequency. Now on y-axis, this frequency we have to make. We can see the frequency numbers here, 5, 12, 7, 2. Is it not? So shall we take multiples of 5? 5, 10, 15, 20. So by the definition, we have done on the class interval x-axis. Horizontal axis, x-axis as class interval, and in on y-axis frequency. Now, let us draw the histogram. Here in histogram, it is given 0 to 10, 5. So, from 0 to 10, it is 5. So, we start from 0 to 10, 5. This 0, this vertical line also is included up to this 5. Then 10 to 20, 12. So, from 10 to 20, you go raise little bit of 10 and we get it as 10 to 20, 12. Then 20 to 30, 7. 20 to 30. After 5, the small part, 7. Then 30 to 40, 2. So, 2 small. So, you can see in this histogram, it comes continuously. That is why this class interval is given. 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40. The class interval is taken on x-axis, frequency on y-axis, and we draw continuously. It's not like a bar graph. Bar graph, in between we have uniformly space will be there. But here it is continuous. That is the difference between histogram and bar graph. Bar graph, you will have this class interval continuously. And this is the frequency. We have to take it on the y-axis. And we draw continuously. Now, we do with the sum. The weekly wages of 30 workers in a factory are given. So they are given class interval from 800 to 810, 810 to 820, 820 to 830, up to 890 to 900, and the frequency are given, number of workers. That is, it shows from 800 rupees to 810 rupees, 3 people are getting salary, weekly wages. Okay, the weekly wages. So 810 to 820, 2 people are getting. Like that, the amount in the class interval they have given. We have to draw the histogram for the given frequency table and answer the following. So first we have to draw the histogram. Then from that we have to answer which group has maximum number of workers. How many workers earn 850 rupees and more? And how many workers earn less than 850 rupees? Okay. But this answers and all, you can take it from the given question directly. Which group has maximum number of workers? You see here in the frequency, which has highest frequency? This one. So this frequency has 830 to 840. So we write for the solution, first part, in the 830 to 840 class interval has maximum number of workers. Next, how many workers earn 850 rupees and more? 850 and more starts from where? See, you can see here, this is 850, this is up to 850, here more than 850. So we should calculate all these. 1 plus 3 plus 1 plus 1 plus 4, totally 10. So we write number of workers earn rupees 850 and more is 10 workers. Understood how we got 10? We see in this class interval how many are getting more than 850. We sum it up, add it up. 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 1, 5. 5 plus 1, 6. 6 plus 4, 10. So number of workers earn 8 rupees 50 and more is 10. Then our what is the third subdivision? How many workers earn less than 850 rupees? So we have to find number of workers earn less than 850 rupees. So that one will start from where? Less than 850 rupees. Here you can see from 800 to 810 up to here, this part. 3 plus 2 plus 1 plus 9 plus 5, we add up. So how much we get? 3 plus 2, 5. 5 plus 1, 6. 6 plus 9, 15. 15 plus 5, 20. So this 20 people get less than 850. So we write number of workers earn less than 850 rupees is 20 people. Okay, so we have written the calculative part. But here we have to draw the histogram. So now we take the graph paper, class interval, we represent it on x-axis, frequency on y-axis, and we draw the histogram now. So now we have taken the graph paper. On the horizontal axis, x-axis, we will draw first. And then we take vertical axis, y-axis. So we turn the page and we try to draw it straight line. You can use the scale also. Now, on the horizontal axis, we have to mention the class interval. Now, the next sum. The marks scored by students in final exams are given below. Marks 0 to 20, 9 students, 20 to 40, 14 students, 40 to 60, 20 students, 60 to 80, 4 students, 80 to 100, 3 students. Draw a histogram and answer the following question. Okay, so first let us draw the histogram. So first what we should do in the graph paper, we should draw the horizontal x-axis line. And then the vertical line, which is y-axis. And where they both intersect, we name it as origin. Then, on the x-axis, we have to write the class interval. So, here class interval, it is given 0 to 20, 20 to 40, 40 to 60, 60 to 80, 80 to 100, multiples of 10. And on the y-axis, the frequency of the students, maximum we have 20. So, shall we take it as, we can take in 4 table, multiples of 4, 4, 8, 12, 16, 20. Then, what is given for us? 0 to 20, 9 student. So, 0 to 20, 9, after 8, a small line we take it as 0 to 20, 9 student. Then, 20 to 40, 14 students. So, after 12, we take that half 12, 14, that middle line, and we make a graph. 12 to 20 to 40. 40, 14 students. Then 40 to 60, 20 students. So 40 to 60, 20 students. Then 60 to 80, 4 students. Then 80 to 100, 3 students. After 4, less than 4. So we have drawn the histogram by making on the x-axis the marks, that is class interval. And on the y-axis, frequency, that is number of students. Now, after drawing this, what and all we should answer now? How many students secured more than 80? So, we see here, how many students secured more than 80? 80 to 100, 3 students. So, 3 students secured more than 80. How many students are failed if minimum pass mark is 40? So, we see here minimum pass mark is 40 means less than 40 how much? 9 plus 14, 23. So, 23 students failed in exam. How many students appeared for exam? So, what we saw over the number of students, everything we add up. 9 plus 14, 23. 23 plus 20, 43. 43 plus 4, 47. 47 plus 3, 50. So, how many students appear? We add up all the number. 9 plus 14 plus 20 plus 4 plus 3. That is 50 students. So, totally 50 students appeared for the exam. So, the question here, when they give with the class interval and the number of frequency, we take on the x-axis class interval, frequency on the y-axis, and since the intervals are continuous, we draw the histogram. After drawing the histogram, we answer the questions based on the sums given. It is very easy. Once if you just, you have to learn, read it, and what they have asked, you should use your logical thinking and write the solution. Till now, we learned how to draw the histogram. Now, let us learn how to read the histogram and answer it. So, in this, they have given a graph. So, in this graph, you can see on the x-axis, age in years, on the y-axis, number of teachers. So, what is given here? 20 to 25, there are 4 teachers are there. In the ages of 20 to 25, 4 teachers. In the ages of 45 to 30, 5 teachers. In the ages of 30 to 35, 6 teachers. In the ages of 35 to 40, 3 teachers. In the ages of 40 to 45, 2 teachers. In the ages of 45 to 50, 5 teachers. Now, what is the question given? From the bars of the histogram, we can answer the following question. How many teachers are of age of 45 years or more, but less than 50 years? So, here you see, more than 45 years, more than 45 and less than 50, how many teachers are there? 5 teachers are there. So, we write the answer as 5 teachers. How many teachers are of age less than 35? So, we see here, in less than 35, what are the numbers we have? 6 plus 5 plus 4. That is 6 plus 5, 11. 11 plus 4, 15. So there are 15 teachers less than 35 years. Okay. So now we know how to draw histogram. The second part is when the histogram is given, we have to read, understand for what the graph is given, for how many in on x and y axis, and we read the question and understand the graph and we write the solution. Let us do one more sums from our NCERT textbook, page 75. You can see in page 75, there is a sum called try this. See here, observe the histogram and answer the questions given below. So they have drawn the histogram. You can see here heights in centimeter and number of girls in class 7. And they have given from 125 to 130, 130 to 135, 135 to 140, 140 to 145, 145 to 150, 150 to 155, 155 to 160. And it is given how many girls are there in the class. Now, let us read the question. What information is given by the histogram? This histogram says, in class 7, heights of the girls. It is given heights of the girls in class 7. Which group contains maximum girls? You can see 7 in between 140 to 145. So, in the class interval of, in the height of 140 to 145 centimeter, maximum student of girls are there. Next, when we turn the page, how many girls have a height of 145 centimeter and more? So we see again, we turn and we see 145 and more means what? Here, from 145 to 160, 4 plus 2 plus 1, which is 7. So we write the solution to be, how many girls have a height and more? 145 centimeter and more is 7. If we divide the girls into the following three categories, how many would be there in each? So we are grouping it. 150 and more is A group. 140 to 150 is group B. Less than 140 is group C. So we see now 150 and more. 150 and more is, we have only 2 plus 1, 3 students. So we write group A has 3 students. 140 to 150 is group B. So we see here 140 to 150. What are all the numbers you have? 7 plus 4. So you can see here 140 to 150 we have only 2 bar. That is 7 plus 4 which is 11. So we write 7 plus 4, 11 students. In group C, we have less than 140. So we see less than 140 how many you have? You can see from 140 down is less. 3 plus 2 plus 1. 3 plus 2 plus 1 how much? 6. So you have in group C, we write 3 plus 2 plus 1 which is equal to 6. So with the given histogram, we understood what is given on x-axis and y-axis and we answered the following question. This is what we say as reading the histogram. So students, in today's class, you learned how to do histogram in the graph sheet. And when the histogram graph is given, how to read and do the sum. Hope you would have understood. Practice it watching once or twice. And any doubts, get clarified. So in the next class, we meet with circle graph. We learn circle graph, which we call it as pie chart. Till that, keep practicing and see you in the next class.